Hi, Chris Wallace from TGW. We're in Fairhaven, Massachusetts today. We're at Titleist headquarters. I'm with Doug Jones. How's it going, Doug?
Good, thank you, Chris.
And I think one of the things that's really unique about Titleist that we found out today is, you know, not only do you guys do all of your own manufacturing, but your manufacturing facility is just a few miles away, so you can really be involved in every aspect of what's going on.
Yeah, you're right. Everything is local here in Massachusetts. While this may be my playground here in the R&D room or within the rooms within R&D, I spend probably a good 30% of my time at the manufacturing facility. Many of the trials that we have to run have to be larger scale. So we have to get out on the manufacturing floor. We interact with them. We get them in tune with what we're developing for the next process. And it works to both development of the product and development of the process to bring it to marketplace.
And it was fun. We had a couple of our TGW customers with us earlier today, and one of the questions that one of our customers had for you was that, as good as these golf balls are, where do you go from here? And you guys sort of had this quizzical look on your face as if to say, what do you mean? I mean, this never ends, right?
Well, no, it doesn't end. It's a continual process. And in some sense, we don't know exactly where we're going to go next. We're always in the mode of discovery. We have people within R&D whose sole focus is new materials, new processes. We don't know exactly what the golfer's going to want next generation, two generations out from there. Something that golfers might have told us they wanted 20 years ago has no application now. We have to be continually improving from where we are, as well as looking beyond where we are to what might be, and then trying to be able to deliver that is probably the challenge that puts the smile on the face as much as anything
else. And one of the things that speaks to that sort of dedication among the whole group here is what you guys have done from a golf ball patent standpoint. You shared some great numbers with us earlier. If you could share those with our users, that'd be great.
The exact numbers sometimes escape me. In the sense, there's about 4,000 patents within the golf ball industry, and the Acushnet company holds about 40% of those patents. We've really made an effort to develop, to put forth our innovative concepts so that not only can we deliver the best products to golfers, but that we are able to maintain our ability in a very competitive marketplace.
Yes. Doug, we appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thank you very much, Chris.